Good afternoon. This is All India Radio. I am Valsa Williams and with me is Abhishek Mukhopadhyay with the Midday News. The headlines. Home Minister Amit Shah holds an all-party meeting to review management of coronavirus in Delhi. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh says Indo-Nepal ties are not ordinary and both countries are bound together by roti, beti and no power in the world can break it. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar says human resources are at the core of India's engagement with the world. National corona recovery rate reaches 51.07%. 169,798 people have recovered in the country. ICMR rejects media reports attributing to it a study regarding peak stage of COVID-19 in India. Under Vande Bharat mission, second flight from Sri Lanka carrying over 150 passengers leaves for Kochi and Bengaluru. Home Minister Amit Shah today chaired an all-party meeting in New Delhi to review the management of coronavirus in the national capital. Delhi Bharatiya Janata Party President Adesh Kumar Gupta, Aam Aadmi Party leader and MP Sanjay Singh and Delhi Congress Chief Chaudhary Anil Kumar attended the meeting. Home Secretary Ajay Kumar Bhalla, Union Health Secretary Preeti Sudhan and senior officials of the Delhi government also attended the meeting.
Mr. Shah yesterday held a high-level meeting with the Delhi Lieutenant Governor Anil Baijal, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan. He announced a series of measures for the national capital after the meeting. He also met the mayors and commissioners of Delhi's three municipal corporations to discuss ways to strengthen the strategy for fighting the pandemic. COVID-19 testing in the national capital will be doubled within the next 2 days and tripled after 6 days in order to check the coronavirus spread. In view of scarcity of beds for corona patients in Delhi hospitals, the centre has decided to immediately provide 500 converted rail coaches to the Delhi government. With this, 8,000 more beds will be available in Delhi and these will be equipped with all facilities in the treatment of COVID-19 patients. House-to-house health surveys will be conducted in containment zones in the capital to improve contact mapping and the survey report will be available within a week. Testing facility will be made available in each polling station. Centre has decided to constitute a committee of senior doctors in AIIMS so that best practices in the fight against corona are communicated to the lowest level. Anupam Mishra, AIR News, Delhi.
Defence Minister Rajnath Singh today said the road built by Border Road Organisation in Lipulekh is very much in Indian territory. Speaking to party workers of Uttarakhand through a virtual rally, Mr. Singh said Indo-Nepal ties are not ordinary and both countries are bound together by roti, beti and no power in the world can break it. He said if there is any misunderstanding between India and Nepal due to the road, it will be sorted out through dialogue. The minister said the link road to Lipulekh, built by BRO, will significantly shorten the time taken for the Kailash Mansarovar Yatra.
भारत और नेपाल के बीच का जो रिश्ता है यह कोई सामान्य रिश्ता नहीं है, यह रोटी और बेटी का हमारा यह रिश्ता है। दुनिया की कोई ताकत इस रिश्ते को तोड़ नहीं सकती है। यदि यह रोड बनने के कारण कोई गलतफहमी नेपाल के लोगों में यदि पैदा हुई है तो मैं समझता हूं कि उसका समाधान हम लोग मिल बैठ कर निकालें। मैं पूरे विश्वास के साथ कहना चाहता हूं, भारत में रहने वाले लोगों के मन में कभी भी नेपाल को लेकर किसी प्रकार की कटुता पैदा हो ही नहीं सकती। इतना गहरा संबंध हमारे नेपाल के साथ है।
The central government today said that the recovery rate reached 51.07% in the country and the total of 169,798 people affected with coronavirus have been cured in the country. In the last 24 hours, 7,419 people have recovered from the virus. Total active corona cases in the country is 153,106. Health and Family Welfare Ministry said that 11,502 new cases of COVID-19 have been reported in the last 24 hours, taking the total number of cases to 332,424 in the country. During the last 24 hours, 325 deaths have been registered, taking the nationwide toll to 9,520. With this, the case fatality rate reached at 2.86% in the country. Meanwhile, Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, said that a total of 1,15,519 tests of coronavirus were conducted by the various laboratories in the country in the last 24 hours. So far, 57,74,133 tests have been conducted. ICMR is continuously scaling up its testing facilities for COVID-19 by giving approval to government and private laboratories. As of now, total 901 laboratories across India have been given approval to conduct the tests for COVID-19, including 653 government laboratories and 248 private laboratories chains. Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, has rejected media reports attributing a study regarding peak stage of COVID-19 in India. The reports, while quoting a study, say that the peak stage of COVID-19 in the country has been delayed by the 8-week lockdown and it may now arrive around mid-November. In a tweet, ICMR said the news reports attributing this study to ICMR are misleading. It clarified that this refers to a non-peer reviewed modelling not carried out by ICMR and does not reflect the official position of ICMR.
The Union Health Ministry has directed that the bodies of suspected COVID-19 cases will be handed over to relatives immediately without waiting for lab confirmation. The bodies will be disposed of with precautions as per the Ministry's guidelines. This direction came in compliance with Home Minister Amit Shah's order in this regard. As per the Home Ministry's directions, AIIMS Delhi has set up a 24/7 COVID-19 helpline number, CONTEC AIIMS, 911-544-155. Callers can take OPD appointments and talk to volunteers, while doctors can talk to consultants through this number. The Health Ministry has also set up 3 teams of 4 doctors each from AIIMS Delhi, DGHS, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and the Government of Delhi, assisted by MCD officials, in accordance with the Home Minister's directions. The teams will inspect major dedicated COVID-19 facilities proposed in Delhi and make recommendations for improvement. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar has said that India today is a source of trusted talent and competitive skills for the global economy. In his keynote address at the 3rd Annual Conference of Protectors of Emigrants in New Delhi today, Mr. Jaishankar said human resources are at the core of India's engagement with the world. He said the focus of the government has been to provide better opportunities and welfare measures to prospective migrants.
The ministry is now seeking to expand this further through skill mapping, collaboration with skill councils overseas, and recognition of prior learning, RPL. We need to find ways and means to capture data in a more robust and comprehensive manner, at the same time striking the right balance between promoting easy emigration while ensuring safety and welfare is imperative.
The External Affairs Minister said India has been engaged in negotiation with foreign governments to provide ease of travel and opportunity through migration and mobility agreements. He said, as with the rest of the country, the protectors of emigrants must rise to the challenge of reviving the post-COVID economy and engaging with the post-COVID world. Dr. Jaishankar said the government is focusing that negative economic consequences of the pandemic on Indian talent abroad are mitigated.
We are currently focused on ensuring that the negative economic consequences of the pandemic on our talent and skills abroad is mitigated. That is influenced not only by the quality of our various bilateral relationships, but the overall helpful approach that we have displayed in regard to health and economic requirements of our partners. It is imperative that we recover our market share as quickly as possible. The coming months will see dedicated efforts in that direction. The contribution that POEs can make to facilitate this national objective is significant.
The second flight under Vande Bharat mission from Sri Lanka took off today carrying over 150 passengers. The Air India flight from Colombo is destined for Kochi and Bengaluru. The first flight last month carried over 170 passengers to Mumbai, Kolkata and Bhubaneswar, while another flight is scheduled next Monday for Delhi, Lucknow and Gaya. Indian High Commissioner Gopal Bagle thanks Sri Lankan government for the assistance extended in making the operation smooth. Around 700 Indian nationals were evacuated by Indian Navy ship INS Jalashwa early this month to Tuticorin. Around 2,000 Indian nationals have registered with the Indian High Commission in Colombo for repatriation. They comprise of mainly small businessmen and traders, stranded tourists and workers. The High Commission has called upon any Indian to reach out to its emergency numbers in case of any help required. The third phase of the evacuation of Indian nationals from Bangladesh under Vande Bharat Mission continued with a batch of 167 stranded Indian nationals leaving Dhaka for Delhi today. The flight departed from Dhaka to Delhi around noon. This was the second evacuation flight from Dhaka to Delhi. Earlier flight had left for Delhi on the 9th of May. Till now, more than 1,965 people have been evacuated from Dhaka under the Vande Bharat Mission.
In Gujarat, Chief Minister Vijay Rupani terms the messages circulating in social media about the reimposition of lockdown in the state as rumours. The Chief Minister clarified that no such plan is even under consideration of the government. In his appeal to citizens yesterday, the CM urged the people not to be misled by such rumours. Mr. Rupani also said the situation in the state is returning to normal after unlocking from June the 1st. Businesses, trade and economic activities have resumed in the state. Therefore, the state government is not considering reimposition of the lockdown. In Mumbai, selected suburban services resumed early this morning on up and down routes over Western and Central Railways for essential staff of the state government only. The Western Railways tweeted that all booking offices opened at all stopping stations. These special suburban services will not be available for general passengers or the public. The Railways has requested not to rush to the stations and to follow medical and social protocols as mandated for COVID-19.
Mizoram has recorded a total of 117 cases for COVID-19, with 5 new samples being confirmed as positive in the last 24 hours. According to an official statement, 5 samples were tested positive out of 682 samples tested yesterday. All 5 new cases have been tested positive while they are staying at institutional quarantine after having returned from different parts of the country recently. 9 new cases of COVID-19 positive have been reported in Nagaland, taking the total number of confirmed positive cases in the state to 177, out of which 89 have recovered. Health and Family Welfare Minister S. Phangnyu Phom this morning tweeted that 9 new cases of COVID-19 positive have been reported out of 418 samples tested. 5 are tested positive from Dimapur Quarantine Centre and 4 from Peren Quarantine Centre.
The Telangana government has issued guidelines for testing and treatment for COVID-19 in private laboratories and hospitals in the wake of increasing cases in the state. Stating that the virus has not transmitted to the community, the minister said the state government is taking all-out measures to contain the spread of the virus. After a high-level review meeting with the senior officials today, State Health Minister E. Rajender informed media that the fee for coronavirus test should not exceed ₹2,200 in private laboratories. Announcing the upper cap for treatment in private hospitals for COVID-19 patients, he said it should not be more than ₹7,500 per day for providing treatment without the need for ventilator. The state government has already announced that it will scale up testing and 50,000 tests will be done in 30 assembly constituencies in Hyderabad and 3 other districts. There is a fake message being passed around with link to a Google form, allegedly by All India Council for Technical Education, seeking inputs from students of universities on the conduct of exams. In a tweet, the Press Information Bureau clarified that AICTE is not conducting any survey and this form is fake.
In a series Expert Speak on All India Radio, we bring you the views of leading medical experts on COVID-19. Talking to AI News, Dr. Uma Kumar, head of Rheumatology Department AIIMS, said that till date there is no proven medical treatment for coronavirus infection.
Only thing which helps is social distancing or physical distancing. Along with it, you have like hand hygiene, washing your hands very frequently, and cough etiquettes like while coughing or sneezing, just cover your face and nose. Use tissue paper or cloth, or if you don't have anything, you can just cough into your elbows. So third thing is using the face mask. For a general public, you can use cotton face mask, and then they have to be very positive. Don't give up, and surely we'll conquer over this virus.
President of the Public Health Foundation of India, Dr. K. Srinath Reddy, said India is in a much better position as compared to the rest of the world as far as the COVID-19 cases are concerned, and the measures taken are yielding results.
Up तक जो नतीजे निकले हैं उससे पता चलता है कि ये वायरस का प्रभाव को रोकने में हम काफी कामयाबी हासिल कर चुके हैं दूसरे देशों के मुकाबले में। आज का हालात जो है उसमें कोई संशय नहीं है कि हमारा हालात दूसरे देशों के मुकाबले में बेहतर है इस वायरस को डट के मुकाबला देने में।
The News Services Division of All India Radio and its bilingual live phone-in program today will bring you a special discussion program on COVID-19. Dr. A.K. Varshni, senior physician from RML Hospital, will participate in the discussion. Listeners can ask questions to the expert on toll-free telephone number 1-800-11-5767. You can also ask questions on telephone number 011-2331-4444 and post queries on a Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts by hashtag AskAIR. This can be heard tonight on FM Gold channel and additional frequencies from 9:30 p.m. onwards. This program will also be available on our website, newsonair.com, and on our YouTube channel, News on AIR Official. You can also follow us on the News on AIR app for updates. You are listening to the Midday News on All India Radio. A reminder of the headlines before we move on. Home Minister Amit Shah holds an all-party meeting to review management of coronavirus in Delhi. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh says Indo-Nepal ties are not ordinary and both countries are bound together by roti beti and no power in the world can break it. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar says human resources are at the core of India's engagement with the world. National corona recovery rate reaches 51.07%. 1,69,798 people have recovered in the country. ICMR rejects media reports attributing it to a study regarding peak stage of COVID-19 in India. And under Vande Bharat Mission, second flight from Sri Lanka, carrying over 150 passengers, leaves for Kochi and Bengaluru. For quick news updates around the clock, follow us on a Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts.
अपने साथ अपनों का ध्यान रखो, बड़े बुजुर्गों का तुम ध्यान रखो, तो बात करो, कुछ मदद करो, कोरोना के चलते याद रखो, घर की सफाई ना भूलना, हाथों को धोना मत भूलना, सुरक्षित दादा दादी नाना नानी अभियान, अपने साथ अपनों का ध्यान।
Amidst the corona crisis, the Prime Minister's office has played a significant role in solving the problems of citizens. Arvind Banerjee, a resident of Bhilai city of Chhattisgarh, says his daughter Anushree was stranded at Kota in Rajasthan during the lockdown. He requested the PMO and his grievance was redressed in a timely fashion.
मेरी बच्ची कोटा में पढ़ रही थी, लॉकडाउन के समय जो है वो वहाँ पे फंस गई थी, तो उस समय मैंने पीएमओ ऑफिस में एक ग्रीवेंस लॉन्च कराई कि बच्चों को इवैक्यूएट करने का कुछ प्रबंध किया जाए। पीएमओ ऑफिस से बहुत अच्छा इनिशिएटिव लिया तीनों, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ राजस्थान और पीएमओ ऑफिस ने बहुत अच्छा समन्वय स्थापित किया और बच्चों को वहां से उन्होंने निकाला, बच्ची हमारी सुरक्षित घर में आ गई। पीएमओ ऑफिस का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। मैंने उनको जिस दिन हमने ग्रीवेंस लॉन्च कराया था और जिस तक हमारा ग्रीवेंस रिजोल्व हुआ तब तक जो है वो कंटिन्यूज ट्रैक करते रहे। मैं नरेंद्र मोदी जी का, भूपेश बघेल जी का बहुत बहुत हृदय से आभारी हूँ।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi has urged people to send their ideas for this month's Mann Ki Baat. In a tweet, Mr. Modi said Mann Ki Baat is a vibrant platform that showcases the strength of 130 crore Indians. He said though Mann Ki Baat is 2 weeks away, people can send their ideas by recording their messages, dialing 1-800-117-800 and writing on the Namo app.
More than 7.8 million cases of the novel coronavirus have been confirmed worldwide, including 4,31,236 deaths so far. According to the Johns Hopkins University, US is reporting the highest number of cases, followed by Brazil and Russia. Beijing's Health Commission have also confirmed 43 cases linked to the largest agricultural market in Beijing, breaking the city's 56-day record of no new coronavirus cases. Actor Sushant Singh Rajput's last rites will take place today at the Pawan Hans Crematorium in suburban Ville Parle, Mumbai. The actor's spokesperson said Singh's last rites will be performed after his father reaches Mumbai from Patna. Rajput, 34, was found hanging in his apartment on Sunday, sending shockwaves rippling through the Hindi film industry and elsewhere. The autopsy conducted by three different doctors has revealed the cause of death as suffocation. The police found out during the probe that the 34-year-old actor was under medication for depression. No suicide note was found from the spot. Known for films like Kai Po Che, MS Dhoni, The Untold Story, Chichore, Rajput was found hanging at this Bandra home on Sunday. Rajput's last screen appearance was Nitesh Tiwari-directed 2019 film Chichore.
Bengaluru Mahanagarapalike is planning to impose a new user fee for the garbage disposal work. The special commissioner in the city corporation, D. Randeep, informed AIR that apart from solid waste management cess collected now, user charges will be charged for clearing garbage from citizens and organizations. More from our correspondent.
Bengaluru generates 4,000 tons of garbage every day and the city corporation spends 1,000 crore rupees to dispose them. Just 60 to 70 crore rupees is generated from the cess charged to the people. Hence, to improve the revenue, the city corporation is planning to impose 200 rupees user charges for those generating below 100 kilogram garbage per month and 600 to 14,000 rupees for those generating above 100 kilogram per month. The special commissioner in the city corporation, D. Randeep, spoke to AIR about plans to improve waste processing plant's capacity from the present 1,500 tons to 3,000 tons.
Because Bangalore generates almost 4,000 tons of waste, of which part of it is dry, most of it is wet waste. So presently there is a slight mismatch in terms of the waste generated and the processing capacity. But we are in the process of enhancing the capacity. As on date, almost around 800 tons of wet waste is being processed in these centers. So these centers are being underutilized simply because of the fact that even the segregation levels in the city are a bit low. So with the new SWM bylaws that we have notified, with steep penalties for non-segregation and ensuring better waste management, we hope to improve the segregation, which will help use optimally processing facilities that we have.
Special Commissioner D. Randeep also informed that talks are on to set up wealth from waste projects in the city. Sudhindra, AIR News, Bengaluru.
In the Union Territory of Chandigarh, three positive cases of COVID-19 were reported today and one patient died. Our correspondent reports with this, the number of COVID deaths has risen to 6 and the number of positive persons found in Chandigarh so far has risen to 355. There are 54 active COVID-19 patients, 295 patients have recovered till now. Noted producer and director Madhur Bhandarkar has appealed to the Indian people to unite in the fight against COVID-19. He urged everyone to follow social distancing guidelines and precautionary measures.
नमस्कार दोस्तों, मुझे उम्मीद है आप अपने अपने घर पे ही हैं। बहुत ही कठिन परिस्थिति है, ना कि पूरे भारत में, पूरे विश्व में, लेकिन हम सबको मिलकर इस वायरस से लड़ना है। हम उन तमाम लोगों को बहुत ही धन्यवाद करते हैं, चाहे वो हमारे आर्म फोर्स हो, पुलिस फोर्स हो, डॉक्टर्स हो, हेल्थ वर्कर हो, जितने लोग जो इस वायरस से लड़ने के लिए दिन रात लगे हुए हैं, हम सब लोग उस वॉरियर्स को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करते हैं। तो स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ, जय हिंद।
In the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, Kashmiri Pandits staged a peaceful rally in Jammu yesterday against the recent killing of a sarpanch from the community and demanded adequate security for all minorities living in the Kashmir Valley. Sarpanch Ajay Pandita was shot dead by terrorists in South Kashmir's Anandnag district on June 8. A daughter of the sarpanch attended the rally, which was taken out under the banner of Kashmiri Pandit volunteers. The International Day of Yoga will be celebrated on the 21st of June. Ayush Minister Sripad Yesso Naik has urged everyone to participate in the Yoga Day from their home, as this year no public congregation has been planned due to COVID-19 pandemic. He has also urged everyone to participate in My Life, My Yoga, the international video blogging contest announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Speaking exclusively to AIR News, Director of the Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga, Dr. Ishwar Basava Raddi said, Yoga can provide great relief from both physical and mental stress.
We have several practices like yogasana, pranayama and meditation or dhyana. Medically speaking, many of the physiological and biochemical tests conducted, which shows that it is helping to reduce the stress, anxiety, is a physiological and biochemical parameter. But at the same time, mental health is not just keeping our body fit and these medical parameters, but it is above all how we react and behave in extreme conditions. That's the most important thing.
Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal today said there are no plans for another lockdown in Delhi. In a tweet, he said many people are speculating whether another lockdown in Delhi is being planned. Mr. Kejriwal said there are no such plans. The centre has also clarified that there is no such plan under consideration. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts.
अरे बबलू, लॉकडाउन खुलते ही टहलने निकल पड़े? महामारी अभी फैली हुई है
सरपंच जी, टहलने नहीं, काम पे वापस जा रहे हैं।
तुझे डर नहीं लगता वायरस पकड़ लेगा?
पहले थोड़ा बहुत डर लगता था, फिर पता चला कि अगर मैंने पूरी सावधानी बरती तो ये बीमारी होने की संभावना कम है। सबसे महत्वपूर्ण है ये मास्क, काम पर मास्क हमेशा पहनूंगा, समय समय पर हाथ धोता रहूंगा और दूसरों से हर वक्त कम से कम 2 गज की दूरी बनाए रखूंगा। खुद को, दूसरों को और अपने परिवार वालों को भी सुरक्षित रखूंगा।
अरे भाई, मेरी जिम्मेदारी बनती है तुझे चेतावनी देना, सो दे दिया।
जब देश के मेडिकल और स्वच्छता कर्मचारी रोज कोरोना वायरस से लड़ने का काम कर रहे हैं तो हमारी भी तो जिम्मेदारी बनती है अपना काम करने की।
बबलू, तुझे कुछ हो गया तो?
हजारों लोग इस बीमारी को हरा कर ठीक हो चुके हैं और अगर किसी कारण मुझे ये बीमारी हो भी जाए तो सरकार ने अस्पताल में हमारे इलाज के लिए पर्याप्त व्यवस्था कर रखी है। ये घबराने का वक्त नहीं, एक दूसरे का हौसला बढ़ाने का वक्त है। कोरोना वायरस से हमें लड़ाई जारी रखनी पड़ेगी और उससे डर कर नहीं, पूरी सावधानी के साथ डट कर चलिए। रुकी जिंदगी को आगे बढ़ाएं, देश को आत्मनिर्भर बनाएं। जय हिंद।
गुजरात सेकेंडरी एंड हायर सेकेंडरी बोर्ड अनाउंस स्टैंडर्ड 12th आर्ट्स एंड कॉमर्स रिजल्ट्स ऑन इट्स ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट टुडे। As per the official press release, a total of 3.7 lakh students had appeared for the exams this year, out of which 2.83 lakh could clear the board exam overall. The passing percentage this year has gone up to 76.29%. Our correspondent reports that girls perform better than the boys in the board exam. Passing percentage among girls is around 83%, while the passing percentage among boys is around 79%. The Mumbai port has handled 321 ships and 9.6 million metric tons of cargo during the coronavirus-induced lockdown period. The Mumbai Port Trust has said that the port is fully operational now in lockdown 5.0. Chairman of the Mumbai Port Trust, Sanjay Bhatia, said, during the lockdown period, Mumbai Port has continued to handle large range of cargo. More from a Mumbai correspondent.
Mumbai Port Trust Chairman Sanjay Bhatia has said the port also continues to handle cruise liners at its facility, enabling signing off of Indian crew on board cruise ships around the world. 6 cruise liners have arrived in the port since June 12. He said some more are scheduled to dock to disembark Indian crew members stuck on these floating luxury hotels since the pandemic halted their operation at various places across the globe. A total of 14 cruise liners are to dock at the Mumbai Port Trust to disembark 10,000 Indian crew members by June 28. Sonali Ghadiyar Patil, AIR News, Mumbai.
Now let us take a look at the weather update for today. National capital Delhi will have partly cloudy sky with possibility of development of thunder and lightning. Minimum temperature recorded was 29 degrees Celsius and maximum will remain around 42 degrees. Mumbai will have generally cloudy sky with heavy rains. Minimum temperature recorded was 23 degrees and maximum will be around 31 degrees. Chennai will have generally cloudy sky with light rain or drizzle. The minimum temperature recorded was 31 degrees and maximum is expected to go up to 40 degrees Celsius. Kolkata will have generally cloudy sky with one or two spells of rain or thunder showers. Minimum temperature in the metropolis was 27 degrees Celsius, while maximum will be around 30 degrees. In Srinagar, minimum temperature was 14 degrees Celsius, while maximum will be around 31 degrees. There is a forecast of mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening. In Gilgit, minimum temperature was 14, maximum will be around 32 degrees Celsius. There will be partly cloudy sky becoming generally cloudy towards afternoon or evening or night. Muzaffarabad is likely to have mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening. The city recorded minimum temperatures of 20 degrees Celsius, while maximum temperature will be around 37 degrees. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Home Minister Amit Shah holds an all-party meeting to review management of coronavirus in Delhi. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh says Indo-Nepal ties are not ordinary and both countries are bound together by roti, beti and no power in the world can break it. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar says human resources are at the core of India's engagement with the world. National corona recovery rate reaches 51.07%. 1,69,798 people have recovered in the country. ICMR rejects media reports attributing to it a study regarding peak stage of COVID-19 in India. And under Vande Bharat mission, second flight from Sri Lanka carrying over 150 passengers leaves for Kochi and Bengaluru. And with that, we end the midday news.